Good morning students. So today we are going to start with our second unit, structure of atoms. So in this we are going to study discovery of subatomic particles. You know what are subatomic particles? The particles electron, proton and neutron present in the atom are termed as subatomic particles. So first of all, discovery of electron. So Michael Faraday, what he did, he showed that if electricity is passed through a solution of an electrolyte, then some chemical reactions occur and something gets deposited at the cathode or anode. It depends on which substance we are talking about. So this was in the year 1830, that electrolysis concept is based on this. Okay, now this results in the suggestion that electricity has particle nature. Particulate means particle nature. So electricity also has particle nature. Okay, now Faraday, he started studying electrical discharge in partially evacuated tubes. Evacuated tubes means those tubes in which vacuum is maintained. Okay, with the help of vacuum pump, if we maintain vacuum in a tube, then that tube will be termed as evacuated tube. Okay, now one such tube is known as cathode ray discharge tube. Okay, this tube is made up of glass and it contains two thin pieces of metal. Those thin pieces of metal act as electrode. Okay, we have to connect them with positive and negative terminal of the battery and they will act as electrodes. Now what he observed that if we take very low pressure and very high voltage we supply, then there is passage of electric current in the gas, or we can say gases start conducting. But what should be the condition? This should be the condition. Okay, now for adjusting the pressure, what we do, we connect it with the vacuum pump, and with the help of vacuum pump we can adjust the pressure. Okay, now when sufficiently high voltage is applied across the electrodes, as I said, the electrodes are connected with source of high voltage. Okay, then current starts flowing through a stream of particles moving in the tube from the negative electrode to the positive electrode. Means when we will supply these conditions, then what we will observe? We will observe the flow of a stream of particles from negative electrode to the positive electrode. Okay, now negative electrode is cathode. Now since these particles are moving from the cathode towards the anode, so they are termed as cathode rays. Okay, now see this diagram shows a cathode ray discharge tube. In this is the tube. This is made up of glass. This and this are electrodes, and this is connected with vacuum pump. With the help of this, we can reduce or increase whatever we want to do. We can maintain the pressure whatever is required. Now see, these two electrodes are connected with the source of high voltage. So this is the apparatus which he used for his experiment. Now he further did something else. What he did, flow of current from cathode to anode was further checked by making a hole in the anode. Now see, here it is anode. What he did, he created a hole, and what else he did, coating the tube behind anode with phosphorescent material. So what he did, this portion of tube he coated with zinc sulfide. Okay, zinc sulfide is phosphorescent. Phosphorescent means where if some particles strike, then they will produce a particular mark which can be seen. So that property is called phosphorescence. Okay. Now, when these rays, after passing through anode, strike the zinc sulfide coating, a bright spot is developed on the coating. So, what is going to happen? From this side, these rays will come, and here, because of hole, they will strike with zinc sulfide coated screen. So, there we can see visible marks, bright spots will be there on the screen. Which screen? Zinc sulfide coated screen. Okay. Now, let us see with this diagram. Okay, now see what we did. We made holes in anode. Now, when rays came from this side, this portion, see, this is fluorescent coating. In this portion, we can see the bright spots. We can see bright spots here. Okay. So, this is what he observed. Now, on the basis of this, what all things he found? On the results of these experiments are summarized as under. Number one, cathode rays start from cathode and move towards anode. So, when we see their movement, then it is from cathode to anode. These rays themselves are not visible, but their behavior, they are not visible, they are invisible rays, but what they are doing means their behavior, it can be observed with the help of certain kind of materials. Just like what we did, we placed zinc sulfide coated screen. So, what we saw bright spots. Now, see, television tubes, nowadays LED and LCD have come, but the previous televisions, they were having this CRT, what we say, cathode ray tube. So, this was there in that. Now, in the absence of electrical or magnetic field, these rays travel in straight lines. So, these rays travel in straight line in the absence of electric and magnetic field. In the presence of electric or magnetic field, their behavior is same as is expected by negatively charged particles. Means if we place, maintain electrical field, then these particles will move towards positively charged plate, which means these particles contain negatively charged particles. Okay, these particles are having negative charge. Now, characteristics of cathode rays do not depend upon the material of electrode. Means, we can take any material of electrode. Similarly, we can take any gas, let it be any gas. If it is cathode ray, then it is unaffected by the nature of gas. Okay. So, what we conclude? We can conclude that electrons are basic constituent of all the atoms. Now, when we determined this much, that there is presence of negatively charged electrons, then what was further? Further was determination of charge to mass ratio of electron. So, Thomson, what he did? He calculated the value of charge to mass ratio. Here, E denotes charge and Me denotes mass of electron. So, this came out to be this much. 1.758820 multiplied by 10 raised to power 11 coulomb per kg. Here multiplication sign is also there. 1.758820 multiplied by 10 raised to power 11 coulomb per kg. Okay. Now, charge in case of electron, charge is negative. So, we write it as minus E also we write. So, don't confuse in that. Minus sign just indicates that negative is the value of charge. Okay. Now, when charge to mass ratio is determined, then it was the time for determination of charge on the electron. So, one scientist known as R. A. Millikan, he developed one method that is called Millikan's oil drop experiment. In Millikan's oil drop experiment, he could determine the charge on the electron, and it was 1.6 0.02 into 10 raised to power minus 19 coulomb. Okay, so this was the value of charge. Now, when charge is known to us, charge to mass ratio is known to us, then we can easily determine the mass value. So, how much it was? 9.1094 multiplied by 10 raised to power minus 31 kg. Okay, so here it is again, cross sign is there. So, we just take 9.1 into 10 raised to power minus 31 kg. Okay, so this must only we take. Now, when everything is known about electron, then what happened? Then two other subatomic particles were discovered. First was proton and another was neutron. Now, what was done? Cathode was modified in the cathode ray tube. What modification is done? It was taken perforated cathode. Perforated cathode means having micro holes. So, such electrode is taken and is made as cathode. Then a new type of rays were also found to be coming out, and they were named as canal rays or positively charged particle rays. Okay. So, what were the characteristics of these positively charged particles? Different characteristics were, first, in case of cathode rays, what was there? Mass of electron was not dependent on material as well as nature of gas, but here mass of positively charged particle was dependent on the nature of gas. Whichever gas we will take, that will decide the mass of that positive particle. Okay, that positive particle was simply positively charged gaseous ion. Okay, now charge to mass ratio of the particles depends on the gas from which these originate, because those particles are coming out from the gas itself. So, whatever is the gas, that will decide the mass of particle, positively charged particle. Some of the positively charged particles carry multiple of fundamental unit of electric charge. Means, what was the positive value of charge? It was in the multiples of what is the value of fundamental unit of electric charge. The fundamental unit value of electric charge is 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 19 coulomb. So, what was found? It was found that the value of positive charge was in the multiples of this value, 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 19 coulomb. Okay, now what was another property? The behavior of these particles in the magnetic or electric field is opposite to that of in case of electron or cathode rays. So, whatever we observed in case of electron or cathode rays, in this case it was found just opposite. Now, hydrogen is the lightest gas, or we say it is the smallest matter. So, for that we calculated whatever the ions were released in case of hydrogen, which were termed as positive particles, they were named as protons. Okay. Now, positively charged particles was characterized in 1919. So, in 1919, these positively charged particles were characterized, means they were given proton name. Okay. Now, after some time, what happened? One more scientist, Chadwick, he performed an experiment. What was the experiment? He took a thin sheet of beryllium and he passed alpha particles through this, means he bombarded this sheet with alpha particles. So, after striking this, he observed a new type of particles and he named them as neutrons. These particles were electrically neutral, there was no charge, and their mass was slightly greater than that of protons. When we do calculations, then what we take almost same value of mass of proton and mass of neutron, but there is slight heavy, these neutrons are slight heavy. Okay, now see, this table is to be remembered. Electron, it is symbolized as E, it has charge this much, it is positive value. Okay, and since this is the basic unit with which we are going to compare, so we take it as one unit. So what we say, it is one unit negative charge. Similarly for proton, it is one unit positive charge and there is no charge on neutron. Mass values are 9.1 into 10 raised to power minus 31, which we will take for calculations. Here it is 1.67 into 10 raised to power minus 27. Till two digits if we talk, then it is same for proton as well as neutron. But if we look after that, then there is certain more value. Okay, so what we can say that for calculation purpose, we are going to take 1.67 into 10 raised to power minus 27 only. Okay, so now whatever we have studied today, on the basis of this, these questions are to be solved. So we studied subatomic particles, who discovered them, how they were discovered, and what are their properties, what are their charges and masses. Okay, this much is to be learned. Thank you.